Straight up, coming to you live from New Start 93 FM here at the UWE Mona campus. My name is Raymond Price. Now, the Marie Berbick Ministries International is hosting its International Women's Conference, Repositioned, and this will be held on November 25, 2023, commencing at 9 a.m. and going up to 5 p.m., and it will be held at the AC Marriott Hotel. We are joined by Reverend Marie Berbick, who will tell our listeners exactly why this event is to be central on their calendar. Good morning, Rev. Berbick. It's a pleasure to have you. Now, Repositioned, that's the theme of the Women's Conference. Talk to us about the selection of that theme and what can patrons expect.
Okay, wonderful. Thank you again, Raymond. Such a pleasure to be here with you. Now, Reposition International Women's Conference, the actual theme of the conference is renewed, restored, and repositioned. Of course, it's a conference which targets women. And the reason why we're doing this conference is because sometimes you see, Raymond, in this journey of life, we come across situations, for example, traumatic situations that can bounce us off the path that we ought to be on. But there will also come a time when you realize that it is time for you to get back on the right track. And you may want to do something to realign and reposition your life, but sometimes you don't know what to do, or you may know what to do, but you don't know how to do it. Mm-hmm. So this is what this conference aims to help women with, to get women repositioned for purpose. So we are dealing with the spiritual, we're dealing with the emotional, we're dealing with the physical. Mind, body, and spirit.
Now, who are some of the presenters, and what can patrons expect? And by the way, it's a women's conference, therefore a conference for women, but it's not a conference that admission is closed to men, is it?
No, it's not. If you want to take the ladies, if you want to take your partner, you want to take your husband with you, they're most welcome to come and be a part of it.
And they should be comfortable to go, right? Because they're not going to be bludgeoned and beaten.
No, not at all. We look forward to welcoming the men with open arms, because we've had queries about this and we have made it quite clear that they are welcome.
Right.
They are welcome.
On your Eventbrite posting, it says, Repositioned International Women's Conference is the ultimate international women's conference designed to break chains and release the sisters into a new dimension. When you watch the kind of movies that I watch, Rev, a new dimension needs a little bit of qualification. So please explain to our listeners what is, like, when they would have attended and when they would have left. What is that newness, that renewal, that repositioning? How does that manifest in their daily life?
All right. So when you have an intention for change or transformation in your life, there's something you're going to want to do about it. And that is why these women will be coming to this conference. When they come, they're in a mindset of, I am not sure what direction I'm moving in. I'm not sure how to go forward or what to do. When they leave, it is our expectation that there will be clarity in terms of their vision for the way forward. They will know what to do. They will know how to do it. But I want to emphasize that the spiritual part of it is very important to us.
Yes.
It is important that they are able to understand clearly that this is not a journey you embark on by yourself. Because I'm not going to be preaching on your program this morning, but just want to remind the listeners, especially the women who may be interested in coming, that the Bible says a man plans his way, his heart plans his way, but it's God who establishes his footsteps. So what we're aiming to do with this conference is to show you what God can do to help you reposition your life. So come with expectation. You will not be disappointed.
Okay. Now, who are some of the other presenters?
All right, wonderful. There is actually a very impressive lineup of speakers. And when I say impressive, Raymond, I'm not talking about names as in somebody being famous. Because sometimes there are people behind the scenes who are powerhouses, and you don't know about them until a particular moment when an opportunity comes. So a lot of these women are women who are hard hitters. They are overcomers. They have been through something in their life and they have overcome. So they are coming with that story to inspire, to transform, and to motivate the lives of others. We're talking about Bishop Christine Haber. She's based right here in Jamaica. Dr. Yana Johnson, she's coming out of the UK. She's the CEO of Yana Cosmetics, which is the first Black-owned cosmetic brand in the UK. There is Pastor Diane Hansen, who is part of MTM TV, one of the co-owners. Dr. Maloney Hunter-Wallace, she is a motivational speaker, successful educator, coming out of the United States, but she's from Jamaica as well. Prophetess Deborah Alexander, she's coming out of Canada. Marcius Kirvin is right here in Jamaica. Lorraine Smith is in the USA. Dr. Charmaine Goodmontine, she's based in Jamaica. Tika Renox is based in the USA. And of course, there is myself. I now live in the United States, but I'm from Jamaica. And I cannot leave out Althea Lane. She's coordinating our lunchtime fashion show. And if you know Althea, Raymond, it's gotta be something.
I do. I feel so blessed. I feel so blessed to be able to say I do know her. Definitely do. And she
She's been through a lot in her life, you know. So she's coming out as an example to women of what you can accomplish despite the odds.
She's an overcomer, as you mentioned earlier, and she is, I'm going to create a name now. She's a give backer. Because she gives back so easily, so frequently, and so much to this country, and in particular, her beloved St. Elizabeth. Now, in terms of the costs, so firstly, the listeners, the costs I'm going to reveal, I am expecting to hear Reverend Burbick tell me that, no, you're quite wrong. Where did you get that information from? Because tickets are $20 regular. This is US, $20 US, $50 US with coffee and break, and $70 for premium tickets, which include a VIP prophetic session and gift bag. Those numbers seem way too small.
No, they're absolutely correct, Raymond, because the intention is not for us to come and try to make money out of these women. We're coming to transform lives. So we're trying to make sure that the tickets are affordable. And the only reason that we're charging is because we have expenses associated. We're going to be at AC Marriott. That's a nice change that you better pay, right? So we got to take care of those expenses. So you're absolutely right. It's $20 for participation in the conference. If you would like coffee break, then that's $50. And then if you would like to have a VIP session the day before the event where we're going to be ministering prophetically, and we're also going to just minister the word of God to those persons who buy the VIP tickets and give you a goodie bag. That's $70. And I don't like to be quoting US dollars. I'm going to try and remember the conversions that we had. The $20 ticket, I think that's 3,000 Jamaican we are charging. The $50 one, I think that's 7,000 and something.
7,000.
And the $70 ticket. Right. It could be somewhere there.
No way.
And the $70 ticket.
Yes, go ahead.
The $70 ticket is 10,000 and change.
Right.
So I'm trying to break it down in Jamaican dollars because, you know, I want to get it.
But first, there's a double deal there because you are using an exchange rate of roughly $150. It's $156.93 today based on the information we have from the Bank of Jamaica. This seems like deal. Right, and
we've done that on purpose.
You've done it on purpose, right?
Yeah, we have.
And there's more to it because you say here that there are 8 sponsored tickets to give away, right? So
we got more.
Oh,
we got about 30 now. People are sponsoring Raymond because the ladies in the United States who cannot make it, they're going out of their way to make sure the ladies in Jamaica, they don't know them, but they want them to be a part of this experience. So we have at least 30 tickets now that we're going to make available to ladies here in Jamaica who are unable to pay for it.
Right.
So all of the cities are coming together to sponsor each other, and this is wonderful.
Wonderful. All right. No. So the event is November 25, and I'm seeing some material here. There is an online process to continue to benefit from the presenters and the work that they do. Talk to us about what happens between Conference 2022 and 2023 and Conference 2023 and 2024.
Okay, so we didn't have a conference in 2022. The first conference we had, Raymond, was in Mandeville in 2017. Myself and Althea Legg spearheaded that. It was really awesome, so we brought it to another level, you know? So there was no conference last year, but definitely we know that we have to do this again next year. And wherever the Lord leads us, that is where we're going to go. However, there is a support group that we started in Jamaica back in 2013 called SUPHER, S-U-P-H-E-R, Sisters United Through Prayer, Healing, Empowerment, and Restoration. We have done a lot of work on the ground with women in abusive and traumatic situations to get them out. In some situations, Raymond, we actually sent people to take women from their homes behind the backs of their abusive partners. I migrated to the United States, so I have not been here on the ground in Jamaica. So we are looking to relaunch and to go even deeper with this program to assist women. The funds that we earn from this conference is going towards an empowerment training program. So we want to set up training for women, train them how be weaving, braiding, nails, etc. Anything that will empower them to be able to leave abusive relationships, because this is one of the main reasons they don't leave. They don't have the money to take care of themselves. So this is what we want to do, and we are trying to get as many women as possible to come together for this cause and to help us.
Yes. All right. Well, thank you so much. You know, I'm going to something broke, a news item broke earlier in the morning. Reverend Berbick, and I'm seeing an update now. I'm going to share it with the listeners, and while you're on, and I'm going to ask you to speak power over this development so that all of this is resolved and there are no losses of life or any, you know, but it's already causing a lot of emotional harm. Several schools across the country have been receiving bomb threats emailed to them. Denby High has dismissed classes, so all students are being sent home. In the previous report, Greater Portmore High was the recipient of one of the bomb threats. This is something that happens in other parts of the world that scare the living daylights out of me personally and out of us in Jamaica. To see a news item like this being carried in Jamaica, Reverend Berbick, is just confusing. So I'm bringing it over to you, ma'am, to just pray power over it so that at the end of the day, no child or teacher or no one at all is injured as a result of what is going on now.
All right. Now, I just want to say to the people of Jamaica at this time, to the school authorities, to the parents, to the students, just remain calm. Remain calm in the face of adversity, because we have a God who sits high. He looks low. He sees the good. He sees the bad. Everything. And the hand of God is upon Jamaica. If the hand of God was not upon Jamaica, worse would have happened to us a long time ago.
Amen.
So right now, I just want to reassure the people of Jamaica that the hand of God is still upon this country. We are still a praying country. There are a lot of prayer warriors in this country, and there are more that God is raising up. So right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, I speak calm over Jamaica, land we love. I speak calm over these schools. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ that every mischief maker who is rising up right now to create disorder and disarray within our schools, Father, we pray that you will expose and remove them in the name of Jesus Christ. Mighty God, we cancel right now every evil agenda that is being perpetrated throughout Jamaica, land we love. We pray in the name of Jesus that angels will be encamped round and about our schools, our school authorities. We pray even now for those in positions of decision making, God, that they will remain steady. Let them not worry, Father God. In the mighty name of Jesus, we speak calm unto their mind right now, and we pray that the mind of God will be deposited for our leaders to make the right decisions in the schools. We pray pray even now for those responsible for security, mighty God, that they too will stand firm in the face of these threats. We cancel and decree in the name of Jesus Christ that they will come to naught. No plan against the establishment of our schools shall come to fruition. We decree and declare now by the power of the living God that every evil agenda is brought to naught. We bind up and cancel the plans of the enemy now, and we decree that no weapon that is formed against our schools, against the school authorities, against the leadership, against the people of Jamaica shall come to fruition. We decree and declare in the mighty name of Jesus that the fire of God will arise and speak for Jamaica. Continue to bless us, God. Continue to stand with us. Put a hedge of protection around us right now, God. Lift up a banner in the name of Jesus and decree and declare to the enemy that is operating through these perpetrators that Jamaica will continue to grow. Jamaica will continue to flourish. We will not stand back and allow evil agendas to persist. In the name of Jesus, we decree and declare victory for the schools, victory for the leadership, victory for the people of Jamaica. We receive this word this morning with power. We receive it with conviction, and we decree and declare it is already done. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
And amen. Well, bless the Lord.
Rev, I know that you didn't accept the invitation to come on the program to have done the ministry that you've just done, but I can't imagine ever that I would have read a news item in this country of that nature. So thank you so much.
You're most welcome. We're always on assignment, Raymond. Always on assignment. Soldiers in the army of God, we're always on assignment. It is well.
All right.
It is well.
And we'll try and talk a bit again with you as we get closer to the 25th to keep the attention and the momentum going toward the event, if that's not a problem.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it. God bless you.
No, and God bless you too. That was Reverend Marie Burbick. And Rev, give us the meaning for Sufer again.
Sisters united through prayer, healing, empowerment, and restoration.
Sisters united through power, through prayer, healing, and restoration. I skipped it when I was introducing you because I was like, I know it's not suffer. How do you pronounce it? What does it mean? So let me confess that. So thank you so much. God bless you, Reverend Marie Burbick. All right, so we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we are in the last leg of the program.